But Saturday sessions, we focus mainly on sugar pushes in this one, looking at different technique points and also some variations on sugar pushes in general, and also a nice fancy move at the end.
So we start off the exercise to get a feeling of counterbalance, compression, and stretch with our partners. So we're just kind of rocking back and forth.
Yes. Focusing on kind of bringing our hips back and grounding ourselves on this little catch here.
Getting this catch with nice kind of straight fingers like that for leaders.
Yes, and like this for followers. Mm-hmm. So we're just hooking our hands into each other. We're not gripping. Mm-hmm. We're just creating an impression like this. And tension like this.
Then we went further with this and we used this to move backwards, a little compression, and then we move forwards from a leader's perspective.
Yes.
Build connection, move backwards, compression, etc.
And for followers, we just talked about using our overall follower technique of just not moving until we feel the impetus to move. So we don't move based on what we see the lead doing, we just move based on what we feel, whether we feel tension or whether we feel compression.
And for leaders, we talked about making sure that this tension and compression is being driven by our body moving rather than our arms moving.
Yes. We also talked very importantly about shoulders. So even if your lead is creating tension, followers, we want you to have your shoulders rolled back just so you're not disengaging and hunching over.
Overall, we talked about making sure we're using our back muscles, which are really strong, and not our arm muscles, which are really weak.
So, on top of all that technique, we also added some footwork.
Yeah, doing like this. Our step, triple step, triple step, our step, triple again, triple. We did some little exercises where we practiced tripling, staying in before building enough pressure to go out again, and then some where we stayed out, just doing step steps. So, for example, our one, two, and triple step.
That was just to reiterate for followers and for leads that the sugar pushes aren't just an automatic thing. Everything that we do and every way that we move should be the result of how we're being led. So if Adam's not leading me to go backwards, then I shouldn't move backwards automatically.
Then we did some twisty sugar pushes, relied on followers doing a little bit of swiveling stuff.
So, yeah, this is mainly initiated when followers do swiveling. That's what makes it easier to lead. It just looks a little bit like this.
And we can mess around with our footwork. We want to. And then we did a move that used this rotation on the side to go triple out, rotate, around.